Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Sandesh Pare. I am currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, I am going to cover the topic that is testing of the mobile applications in Android. So, we'll see the learning outcome. That is at the end of this video. Okay, you will be understand the different techniques which are used to test the mobile applications, and you will came to know the benefits of the application testing. So let us start with the introduction one. Okay, why testing is necessary in any app development? Okay, it is the biggest question. As we are familiar with the software engineering also, okay, testing plays an important role in the app development, okay, because we have to ensure or we have to confirm that particular developed app is working as per the demand or not, okay. Otherwise the whole propaganda of the application development will discredit. Okay, that should not happen. Okay, it will create a very bad impression on the consumer. That's why the testing plays a biggest role rather than development. Okay, so testing is important than development. Okay, because some mistakes may be happen at the development time, but one should not be obsolete the particular mistakes or the errors or the non-functions, okay, in the app development during the testing. Testing is nothing but the procedure of the validation. Okay, it means a certification that particular application is working as per the demand and as per the design. Okay, and conformance with the functional requirement. Okay, means in this phase we are going to check only the functional requirements. That is, it is working as per the demand or not. Okay, and conformance with the non-functional requirements means here the procedure of optimization comes into the picture. Okay, means we have to give that is the required output, but can we reduce the code, can we reduce the resources, can we reduce the process which are required for the app development here. Okay, means optimization is optimization is performed in the non-functional requirements confirmation. Okay, so testing confirms the optimal usage of resources, such as first one is the available memory. Okay, the desired mobile application should use the minimum memory. Okay, in terms of the storage and in terms of the processing power, okay, it should use the minimum memory, then and then only it will consider as the good one. It should use less battery backup. Okay, if your app is working properly but it is consuming a high battery, okay, high battery power, then it will not hit in the market. Okay, it will create the problem according to the consumer one. Okay, and processing power is also same. That is, it should take a less processing power. Okay, otherwise if your app is working correctly but it is taking too much processing power, then the mobile device on which it is installed and playing, it may be get hanged. Okay, so it is not good. It should support on the diverse set of devices. Okay, because there are number of devices on the in the market which are available in different screens, sizes, different colors. Okay, so with different densities also. Okay, so your app must be supported by the all of them devices. Okay, because the particular developer doesn't know that on which device the particular app will be get installed and used. Okay, and if it is not supporting one, then it will create a bad impression on the consumer, and in the market the application may be get flopped. Okay, and performance according to the different carrier networks. Okay, means certain apps are there in market nowadays using the mobile data while performing the operations. Okay, so during this, it should not consume the high amount of the data, mobile data. Okay, otherwise, it will again create the chaos in the market. And according to the security point of view, the app must be provide a security to the data which is in the mobile device or regarding the application data. Okay, the application should be trustworthy. Okay, that particular data of any user should not be shared with any other one. Okay, and not misused also. Okay, it is the main aim behind it. And next is the usability of the app. That is, a particular app should be very easy to use. As we can see, components of the testing of Android applications is nothing but you can see as in the screen that first testing the project. Okay, under that package. Okay, here the hierarchy is shown, means it is divided into the subtask. Okay, and again packages are divided into the suits, and then again suits are divided into the test cases. Okay, according to this particular cases, that particular function or that particular part of a code is get tested, that is working, it working functionally and non-functionally correct or not. Okay, so let us start with the activity. Okay, as we know, what is the activity? It means it is not a single process one. It means suppose you are downloading a particular file, at that time you are playing the music at the background. Okay, and at the same time you are surfing in the gallery also. Okay, so these all three tasks are not the separate one according to the activity. Okay, means these are three different tasks all, but it is one as whole considered as the one activity. Okay, so while testing the activity, there are mainly two functions are there, that is setup and tear down. Okay, as you can see in the code, that is at the setup is line number 6 and 13 number line shows the tear down function. Okay, at the setup your activity will be get created and a particular activity is assigned to the text view as you can see. And in the teardown, it is again after the testing it gets nulled. And another one aspect is the service one. Okay, service is nothing but it is different from the activity. Activity is particular regarding to particular time. Okay, but service is not like that. It is continuously playing at the its role at the background one, and it is providing the service to the user. Okay, and a particular service may provide the service to the different activities at any time. Okay, so while testing this service, a test case should be either test that is a particular business logic is implemented as a long running task. Okay, means continuously running or not, and execution of the appropriate methods. Okay, like binding of particular resources or to starting any activity, and unbinding the resources or the whatever processes that are called at the proper time or not, it is handled by the testing of the service. Okay, this is the code for the testing service. Okay, setup and tear down methods are used in this also. Okay, as you can see, intent is used. Okay, intents are generally used to exchange the data between exchange the user data. Okay, it is the main function of the intent. So new intent is arised here. Okay, by using the counter service class, and then at the tear down again it is a released one. Okay, this is regarding service. So there is one question for you guys, the how testing is different from the activity. As I said, activity and service are different. Activity is time consuming, time limited, and service is continuously running at the back end and providing the service to different activities, and it performs the certain operations like starting and stopping of the particular process call, and binding or unbinding of the resources also. Next one is the content provider. It actually plays a role to exchange the data between different applications. And while testing this, we have to test mainly three things. That is validation of the appropriate resolution of uniform resource identifiers, or the definition of MIME, okay, that is a multi-purpose internet mail extensions, and a result of CRUD operations. It means recording related to the database. We have to perform these operations, that particular results are valid or not. So again, for the content provider testing, there is setup and teardown functions are there, and you can see the particular uniform resource identifier is again passed here, okay, and at the teardown it is released one. So app testing is mainly checking the five main things. That is functionalities of the application, that is working not correct or not, usability of the applications, then performance of the application, and then network which is used by the application, and then security of the data, which is regarding the application data or the maybe device data, okay. So these five things are mainly covered while the testing of the mobile application. These are some references I used to make this video. Thank you.